Sure, let's accept. What's up to you two? All right, so apparently pushing this pawn in front of the rook is a thing you can do in shogi. This is like the most crude attack I can construct. He's gonna push this, I assume. I could trade bishops, although I hear that there's really not much point in doing such a thing. I'm gonna apply pressure against the bishop, though. And he castles this side. I'm not expecting him to castle that way. So at this point, I am well beyond out of book. Let's bring our silvers forward. Oh, would you check that out? I fell to a bishop fork. Okay. Yep. So let's block the fork. It's quite accidental, I assure you. Yeah, I think this is a climbing silver attack. I don't know. I saw an example of the climbing silver attack, and it's kind of sort of what I'm trying to do. I'm not sure if I'm doing it right. But, given that my silver here is defended, I'm probably doing okay. And I don't know, I need to place the bishop eventually. It's too bad this gold's, well, no. There's so many ways I could mess this up, it's funny. But yeah, if I push this, he's gonna drop the pawn back here. I could push there, takes, silver takes. I'm hitting the bishop again, bishop runs. I'm not sure what results next. If I were to just lead off with the knight move, he pushes on the fourth file. So I'm kind of running, trying to find an idea. Oh, I'm sorry, pawn up here wouldn't attack the bishop at all, so you just take my silver, I take there, he takes back. Let's just put the bishop back. Because I don't see what else to do. I should castle at some point. Okay. What's the point of that maneuver? Okay, so yeah, he's got a silver that's starting to climb too. Having these golds on the back rank makes it really hard for the opponent to attack stuff, I've noticed. So I'm gonna walk my king out of the danger zone. We've both got a bishop in hand. Just need to be a little patient with this attack here. Okay. So the knight's the only thing defending the silver. It's harder for players to defend things in shogi than it is in chess. So let's get my king out of harm's way. So he's setting up some kind of fortress. I'm just gonna tuck my king back here. Oh, he's hitting two of my pawns again. Because pawn forks are a thing that I just have difficulty seeing. Well, this time he's definitely getting one of the pawns. Yeah, it's hard to defend things in this game. If I at least put my rook over here, I'm threatening to harass. Well, not very much. Goodness. Damn. I don't know how to defend this stuff. Basically, I keep thinking that my pawns move differently than they actually move. So, we're gonna push. This one I see is defended. And he takes my other pawn. Couldn't do much about that as far as I see. At least I can defend this guy. So, if he gets careless, maybe I get a king and rook fork, which would be hilarious. That aside, I'm not sure what I'm aiming for here. Could try to trap his bishop, but that's kind of a long way off. On the other hand, I mean, what am I doing? Yeah, we'll keep his silver away. Okay, so I see he's. He's trying to get his silver forward here. It's not just a defensive move. It also gives the bishop more places to go. It's a good move. So what am I supposed to do here? Could try to break in the center. Things are okay. I dropped a pawn against a Wandan, so I might not win this. But there's so much more to shogi than just a single pawn. Well, having given the pawn, let's go forward somehow. He might be able to just drop. No, he can't drop the pawn there, because that would be illegal. Okay. I don't understand this move. I guess he's intending to just push it a second time, and I need somewhere to go. Well, that would be stupid. I'm finding all the bad moves in this position. It's pretty funny. All right, so I'm going to attack. Defense is no fun. It's always time to attack. So here we go. I'm probably going to be forced to sack my knight. Yeah, after playing a few games, yeah, it occurred to me just how similar this game is to Crazy House. So now I could put the knight there, and if silver takes, bishop takes, knight takes here, hitting the golds. That can't be terrible. At least it's better than just giving away the knight. So, go ahead, take it. I guess the worst part, though, is that his bishop ends up on a good square after all this. So, I'm gonna get me a gold. Yeah, now I'm in check. How do I want to block that? Not with a pawn, but I guess I just run away, right? If he had a gold, this would be terrifying, but he doesn't. And he has no way to immediately obtain one. So I'm just gonna tuck my king away and hopefully not get mated. Okay. Ah, there's the gold he was looking for. I see. That's kind of a problem. So the question is, if I take here and promote, he takes my rook, I check with the silver, he goes away, and then I mate him with the gold. So I actually checkmate first. Now if I take there, he's gonna take my knight, or whatever it is once it's promoted. Do I have better? I don't know. If I had a forced mate though, it's probably not gonna start with this. This is tricky. Well, we're gonna take, and yeah, he's gonna do the good move. So now I need a plan. Maybe taking the gold wasn't the right idea. I don't know. In any event, I've got to defend myself. So, oh man, this is getting ugly. Oh, my rook gets trapped there. This is what I get for trying to defend that pawn. Yeah, I'm just gonna tuck away over here, I guess. So he takes my gold. I just go over and defend. If he had another silver, he'd be able to win my rook outright, but he doesn't. So what am I afraid of? Okay, I think I just hit the. No, that's not good. Placing it here, you just do pawn takes. And this defends a silver, so everything's defended. Not sure what he's up to. Oh, he wants to win my rook now. That's not good. I mean, he could even take this and promote his bishop. So this is pretty dire. How do I attack? Got to place my pieces somewhere to attack. Seems as good as anything, although maybe a rank back would be better. Not sure that does very much. Disgusting. Just shows how bad my position is. Oh crap. Is he gonna see it? He's probably gonna see it. I missed it. And by it, I mean the knight drop winning the rook. Yeah, you're absolutely right. Yeah. I didn't even. Like, I wasn't reading what you were writing, but I saw it. I saw the tactic. I've kind of committed to this strategy where. I mean, if I take a tempo to free the rook, I'm not winning this. I kind of have to pursue an all-in strategy. So, here we go. Let's check. I have to take it. Well, this actually just cuts off the rook, so he doesn't need to take the rook. He's doing well without it. Maybe I'll manage a king run like you, or like Spinal Tap managed the other game. Maybe my king just somehow, by some miracle, makes it unscathed across the board. Unlikely, but no, especially unlikely given the rook being so active. But maybe possible. Meanwhile, I'm just threatening pawn drop here. He takes, I take, he rook takes. I hit the rook. Who knows where the rook goes? I guess he probably checks me. So I need to set that up a little bit better first. I might have other ideas too. Okay, so he promotes his bishop. Actually, I could push my pawn and allow myself to get closer to his king, I guess. I don't have enough pawn. Well, this might work. He's threatening just to go there. All right, so I've got to do something crazy. I have to defend the square, otherwise I get mated. But I can counterattack while I'm defending. And I can place some of my pieces, which I've been neglecting to do for some time now. So I can't pursue his bishop, so I have to go back. Yeah, now he wants to place another piece, right there. What do I do? I guess I defend with my silver, right? So if he places a piece, I capture, he captures, I capture. Right, bishop takes, must have some purpose. Oh, he's just reducing my forces there. My king's not so safe in the corner. Oh, wait, it's not so safe out of the corner either. I take, he checks, I take back, he. That's not quite mate. Oh, wait, no, I'm mated. I think I'm mated. We'll see if there's some way out. Nah, I'm just toast here. Yeah, so knight takes, and there is no escape. So yeah, GG. I don't know, I guess I'll offer a rematch. I doubt that you'll take it, but I did not play so convincingly that game. All right, it appears I'm not getting a rematch, so let's go find another opponent. So yeah, obviously I didn't have any, didn't know what to do against that formation. I played quite weakly against it. So it says I played static rook versus fourth file rook. And I wasn't sure what to do there. Normally, my attack with the rook has gone much more strongly. And I wasn't sure how to play this static rook formation. I've tried other formations, but I don't know, they just seem challenged. I need to lift my rook. That's my deal. Alright, so. Am I seeking a game? Yeah, I am. See how long it takes to find an opponent. Maybe I need to accept somebody else's seek. I just don't know if I should be going much higher or much lower, looking for an opponent. 5:30 is fast, man. All right, I mean, I guess I could play against this guest, right? I have no idea how good they are. Yeah, sure. Let's play him. Right, he accepts my challenge. We say hi, what's up? Develop the bishop. So I just do this ridiculously crude pawn attack thing. And then try to follow it up with my silver. So I think this is called climbing silver. Pretty sure that's what it's called. And then I can tuck my king away. And bring my other silver forward. I'm not sure what to do here. Think just continue the pattern. Just make sure not to put all my pawns on squares where the bishop takes them. Oh, that's why I couldn't get the rook lift in, is because I could never get this pawn exchange to get the tempo to move up the rook. So, yeah, we will pursue this very aggressive maneuver. Just bringing all the generals forward. Seems most unwise, but what you gonna do? So hopefully I'm not missing something tragic. I keep forgetting all these holes in between my generals, though, so that's ultimately what's going to get me one of these days. Oh, right. So somehow I thought that that gave me initiative, but clearly it does the opposite. Okay, so we retreat. Meanwhile, he pushes. How can you push everything like that? I don't get it. But I could push here, he takes, and I push again. Okay. Climb, silver, climb! Hopefully he doesn't play like a piece right in front of the rook. Normally you'd want your opponent to put a piece in front of the rook, but here, that would actually help defend some of his squares. Do I have a hole in my camp? Oh. So yeah, pushing my silver allowed this dude in. Gosh, this is ridiculous. I shouldn't have to bring both my golds to the center like that. Because doing so leaves all kinds of holes on my back rank. So he protects against my future pawn drop. Meanwhile, he's attempting to fork my pawns here, and I just go back. So I snatch up this pawn, apparently, and defend my own. I'm not sure what he's up to. But playing safe is definitely not what he's up to. So I cut off his bishop. I'm just trying to keep his gold at bay. And if I could find the time, I would just take this pawn, but I don't really have time to do that. Meanwhile, I'm kind of threatening this pawn push in the center. It's interesting. Well, pawn push. No, he's not going to do bishop takes knight. This isn't chess. You don't trade a bishop for a knight. This king's tucked behind a silver. I'm just gonna push over here because I don't see what else to do. He overextended. Yeah, like this pawn formation is really weird looking. He hasn't moved very many of his pieces to support it, and he's going quite far. This looks very overextended. I mean, yeah, you don't lead an attack with your bishop. Oh. Damn it, why do I see these things too late? Not that I would see them to begin with, but. Oh, wait, he doesn't have the pawn in hand, though. If he had the pawn, he would just place it there and hit my silver, and I'd be unhappy again. Yeah, but this bishop can't go any further forward. So. Alright, so he did that to get a pawn into his hand, but I don't know why. Still not sure what my rook's doing. Or my bishop. Oh, but earlier I was saying I could push this. And things could get interesting if I push there. Because then I have a knight pretty far advanced. Not, I guess not far enough to cause any real trouble. I'm a bit nervous about trading pieces as it makes things much more difficult to calculate. I could just bring my gold forward to support this position a little bit better. And leave behind this wide open hole somewhere. I'm not even sure where the hole is. Maybe I just drop the rook back to the first rank. It covers a lot of territory. It can swing really far on the first rank. And it's not getting anywhere on the second, because my opponent's playing this really weird formation. This way, I can lift all my generals forward by a rank without being too afraid of stuff dropping on my first. Stuff being, I guess, gold, silvers, and bishops. Yeah, this king is starting to castle a little safer there. Guess I'll run. I think this is as good as my setup's gonna get. So my idea of pushing my center pawn's not quite panning out. Because then this pawn takes, and I don't have a follow-up. Okay. Maybe this is the weak point, though. So maybe somehow. Maybe I just rook here. It's really weird. I've never seen anything like it for Shogi, but. I mean, how else do I break through? How do I break through this mess? It's the big question. I mean, maybe I have to defend this and then allow my silver to move up. I don't know. Could put the pawn here and give up on the idea of trying to win the pawn and just sack it outright. That really opens things up, though. I don't like that. There's got to be something here, but what? Where's my play? Oh, my pieces are so confined. Maybe I do push. He takes, knight takes, knight takes. Knight's hitting my silver. That doesn't work. Maybe I push here. Pawn take. No, I mean, that just gives up a pawn. All my pieces are really badly locked up. There's got to be somewhere I can go. I could go bishop back. If my bishop's not getting out by any other way, this might be the one way out. Fact that I even have to try that is kind of ridiculous, but there are setups where you do do this, so this makes some degree of sense. How does he defend that? Maybe by some miracle I get my pawn back here. All right, so which piece do I capture with? How about the one that's not defending my center pawn? Takes, silver takes, silver takes, then takes my pawn. That's really aggravating. Oh wait, no, that's defended. So I could capture either way. I'm gonna capture toward the center. So I got my damn pawn back. Took me a while, but I finally managed to get it. I think I managed to do so without hanging material, which is pretty uncommon for me. So, there's got to be some. Oh, what's this? Okay. I get that he wants to make some kind of weakness in my camp, but I don't see where. All right, your move, buddy. So, okay, he wants to place the pawn here at this point. Man, he's extending far. So if I do that, he just repeats the knight move again. Maybe I take it. Just let him put his pawn here. And then drop my silver here and see what he comes up with. Do I have better? Could move my silver up. I could drop a silver. So put this here, puts a pawn there, I'm forced to go forward. I could lead with a knight. It's kind of scary because he just drops the knight here. Okay, so I'm going to ask his knight what it's doing up here. Think lance takes makes sense. No, because then he just. I mean, either way, he's advancing on me. This is okay too. No. Basically, I'm getting mauled over here. Yeah, he just pushes his pawn, and my lance is stuck. That I did not expect. I mean, there's some reason to that, but. Just doesn't seem like the right move in this position. Okay, so I'm facing some danger. But it's my turn to attack, is it not? I have no attackers in hand. Well, this is gonna hurt. Wait, I guess I could just take that, right? Nothing's defending it. Mean, he's gonna do bishop takes. That's no surprise in itself. So he's hitting my generals. He's kind of forced into this position anyway. But this is what convinced me to just go for it. So I'm facing a promoted bishop, but I'm not afraid. Is that where I want to place? Is this really what I have in mind? I wish I could place in other spots near the king, but none of that's really available to me at the moment. Like, I can't put a pawn here. Knight here would have been interesting, though. So, I've got a bear king. I'm pretty sure I'm in huge pressure here. That didn't actually help me at all, did it? That just made my job way more complicated. Not sure what to do. Oh, crap. Yep, so that's just me. You got me, buddy. I don't know why, but maybe the dude wants a rematch. Probably not, because I played like a buffoon. but I'm learning, so there's that. Basically, I'm finding that this castling the king in the corner thing is not so easy, and it spends vital tempi. So maybe that's not what I want to do. So we'll challenge the guest, dude. Sure, why not? Ah, he accepts. All right, what's up? All right, so we're gonna push this. I really think that this one Don title is perhaps not accurate. Oh. Well, I guess, yeah, he doesn't have to move. I mean, he might want to. Oh, there he goes. So this whole climbing silver thing where I just run my silver up and try to chase his bishop is not working out so well. Also, a rook on the first rank is pretty much useless. The rook on the second might look awful from time to time, but it's okay. The rook on the first just does nothing. It's not gonna help you, man. So I'm gonna try this climbing silver again. Maybe the notion is that I'm supposed to tuck my silver in front of my first file pawn. I don't know why they keep doing this one. This, I guess that keeps my silver away for a brief time anyhow. So if I push, and I push again, pawn takes, lance takes, lance takes, silver takes, bishop takes. I suppose this is the point. But is there no way I can also... like if I redouble my efforts here, try to bring my other silver this way. And this time, if trades are offered, just trade the damn pieces. So I have to play this to stop him from advancing the pawn. There's got to be some way I can advance this further, right? How am I supposed to break through this? This is gold protects the center. I'll use my knight to hit the square, and then the knight's going to hit the bishop. I think at my level of skill in this game, castling is overrated. So I'm gonna see if I can pursue an attack without castling. It's a bit insane, but it might be doable. It's the best way to learn is to experiment. So pawn takes, lance takes, land takes, silver takes, bishop takes. I'm potentially losing the knight there. But if I push this in the middle first, pawn takes, bishop, silver takes, I guess. Knight takes, I hit the silver. But what's the profit in that? I don't know. I could play my rook to the fourth rank file. That kind of makes this stronger. That's a huge understatement. Yeah, playing my rook to files makes attacks much stronger. So I debate, do I go here or there? This looks extremely tempting. Yeah, we're going for it. My rook is active. So I'm playing against an opponent who knows various formations. And I'm kind of inventing formations on the fly here, just whatever it takes to make this thing not fall apart. But I think I'm doing okay. This king is in the middle, which it shouldn't be. And my king's in the middle, but I don't care. Okay, so now he's put his piece right in the line of my attack. If he had a bishop here, that would actually hit the silver. So I shouldn't open this up and invite the bishop in. I could open this file though. Yeah, I didn't see. Like, I thought I had something strong here. I think I just flat out miscalculated. So, okay, away I run. Did I mess up? What's the point of that move? I don't get it. I mean, now I take. Bishop takes is the only recapture. I can block the bishop. Pawn takes, silver takes, bishop takes. Not so good for me. Oh, I see. He's trying to trap my silver. Sneaky, sneaky, sneaky. Except my knight takes, so it's not such a big deal. So, I'm sure I've got a host of problems here. Yeah, this isn't doing so well. So, I have to do this capture. Control some more squares that I was not controlling earlier, but well, I'm seeing two of my pawns are not even on the board. So the point of me advancing the gold earlier so I could help defend this if I need to, like if the bishop hits it, I'll have another general at the ready. Also, my general could chase down a potential drop here on the second file. I guess his bishop's going to run back. Just given this really unique position. I did not expect this forward move. I don't see the purpose of him going forward like that. Right. I mean, yeah, that's a logical follow-up, and my knight's trapped, so so it's tactics time. I could push this pawn. Pawn takes. Lance takes. Lance takes. Pawn drop here. Doesn't do much. What else could I do? These two golds are super annoying and make it really difficult for me to attack. I'm just trying to find some permutation of stuff being taken here that allows me to continue attacking. Pawn push, pawn takes, rook over. My knight's still trapped though. really wanted this breakthrough in the middle to work. I don't know, maybe I do push on this flank or something. I'm kind of a sitting duck, to be honest. Well, for whatever reason, I keep concluding this is forced, even though I really don't like it. So, but I can't play something like that. That just doesn't work at all. Not even remotely close to working. All right, we're pushing over here. At great peril, so I'm gonna hang all my stuff basically and see what happens. I just don't see an alternative. Oh, well, by some miracle, I'm distracting him over there, apparently. I mean, I guess I could put a. No, I can't put the pawn there. That's illegal. I could sack a pawn here and deflect his bishop, but why? This sucks. Oh yeah, I should just take this. Oh wait, no, he's not gonna take my knight. I was gonna say I walked into a knight fork, but no, my knight's defended. I might be losing material other ways, but I'm not losing to this rook forking my knights. It's not like he's just winning this knight with the rook. So I'm okay over there for an instant. But yeah, a rook on an open board is a terrifying thing. And I guess that's the sort of thing I should be trying to do here is lift my rook in some kind of terrifying way. Freddy tried to do so on the center file, and it's not going anywhere. Why don't I just trap my bishop while I'm at it? Oh wait, now if I place here, takes, takes, drop, takes, takes. Oh, no, he's got that amply covered. It's still not close. I'm gonna push this because I don't know what I'm doing. Take here. Okay. So he's got a knight. I don't understand why he did that. I'm gonna learn something this game. I've got four pawns at the ready. And that's four opportunities for me to double my pawns. Well, I can't back up now. Still, how many pawns can I have in hand? Okay, well, at least I'm getting his gold away from the center as I run away. So, that having moved means I can place this here. Basically, now I've finally got enough that I can just blast my way through on the center file, or at least attempt to do so, and have some reasonable chance of success. But yeah, if I could get my rook and my bishop on open lines, that would be a good thing. He runs. Okay. I could put a pawn there, but why? What would that do? In some nebulous sense, it would restrict his king. Oh, I could put a pawn here. That's actually pretty scary. No, but then he moves the knight away. So I'm not winning the knight. All right, so let's get this gold out of here. Alright, and that expands the scope of the bishop slightly. Oh, I guess he just takes twice here. But tactics abound. Didn't see that. So, yeah, he's got bishop takes pawn coming up. You look at that hole. All right, bring it. Where's this knight going? I mean, I recognize this kind of extending is what got me killed last time, but I kind of have to do it. He's promoting the knight. All right, so our battle begins. Oh, my rook's not on the center file. Well, that kind of slows my attack now, doesn't it? Shit. I trapped my bishop, except it has a single flight square. Actually, two flight squares. I could take this pawn in the middle. Still, I'm playing with fire here. I don't exactly know what I'm doing. Yep, this is 81 Dojo. We're playing some Shogi. Hopefully not losing too badly. Alright, so he promotes the rook. Gotta have some attack here, no? Forward we march. Need to keep remembering how pieces move. Alright, so, oh, that's scarier than I thought it was. That's not good. Alright, so I'm giving a bishop, basically. Ooh, what do I do? I can't move the bishop away, because I get mated. Alright, bring it. Let's check. I hope he pins my rook, and I hope that this is... I don't have a general, so there's no checkmate. If I had a general, just drop it right in front of his king, that'd be mate, but there is no general. That's not good at all. I don't even want the silver, but I mean, what else am I doing? So, I need a plan. Oh, the golds are the ones that can't move diagonally backwards. So this is a gold, this is a silver. I'm gonna lose a lance if I do that. What else do I do? Here we go. Going for broke. Probably gonna lose a ton of material in this attack, but my rook will find its way to an open file somehow. So I don't want to let his rook unopposed on my second rank. So I have to swing over here again. That way if he does take with the rook, I'm not just letting him checkmate me. But yeah, I'm giving away tons of material. And my rook's not even finding an open file. So, my best chance of winning here is to win on time. Just totally not gonna happen, if you know anything about people playing this variant. They don't lose on time. Okay. Yeah, he's getting another one of my pieces pinned. To be more accurate, I've got to run off to the side here. If I pin myself, I'm just done for. I need every piece I can in my attack. Especially considering that I don't even have an open file, and he's got both bishops, so I don't have an open diagonal either. Rook trade might help because he might accidentally walk into a mating net. But that aside, this isn't looking so good. I guess the moral of the story is that I should use my gold toward the center more aggressively. It's just really hard to know where to put the gold. Yeah, these lances are the ones that only go directly forward. They're basically just big pawns. Yeah, I've got plenty of nothing here. So he's probably threatening some kind of check here and advancing that dude. I have one attacker on his side of the board, and it's nowhere near his king. This might be bad. All right, we're gonna take. Now I'm just gonna see if how close I can get my attackers before he mates me. All right, so he's got a general and a dragon. Here, let's stick the lance on the file. About the best I could do with the lance. Of course, this is going to provoke him to. Oh. I was going to say this provoke him to move the king. Does he have a mate here? Am I just getting insta-mated? I'm not seeing it. Okay, if I lift that, he just plays the rook to the first, and I still don't see an instant mate. No, that is instant mate there. Mate in two, which they call here mate in three, but let's put my rook on the center file. So if this isn't something waiting to happen, I don't know what is. So if I place my pawn here, I mean, given my lack of a general, I'm not checkmating him anyway. I don't know why he's playing this way. This is a really strange way to play, I think. All right, he brings his dragon to the first. He's gonna take my gold. I run away. And then he checks me with my gold. And I'm just gonna keep running, because what else can I do? I could do pawn on the first and he just do gold takes. I'm not doing myself any favors that way. Oh, he's threatening. Oh, crap. I didn't see that. This is not so good. If I play that, he just drops the gold here and it's mating immediately. So I'm sacking my rook. I'm more than a bit dead here. I can't block with the rook. If I block with any other piece, it's hopeless anyway. Let's just keep running. Oh, does he have a mate? Ah, this is mate. Yep, you got me. Oh, yeah, no, I say I am mated. No, I say here I am lost. How is that not mate? Okay, yeah, he's gotta go. How is that not. Oh, my lance takes it. I take. Rook takes. I don't know. I didn't see this. So what now? I mean, he's got something like this, right? That's gotta be mate. So, all right. These games are difficult. All right, we'll wait for a game. Shogi is the easy version of Crazy House, but it's still plenty difficult. I've played both Shogi and Crazy House. In my opinion, just feels like Shogi is, I don't know. Variations are a lot longer. And it's not, I don't know. It's difficult to compare the two, I suppose. I want to say though, somehow that it just feels like I'm doing okay at Shogi. Despite getting blasted so badly. Whereas at Crazy House, it just feels like I don't even have a fight. Here, even if I hang things, I'm okay. But I'm super frustrated that my attacks aren't working. How many games have I lost in a row? Is this keeping track? I think I've lost four in a row today and haven't won any. I think that's the case. Okay. I don't know why this guest dude logs in. Or, I'm sorry, why he doesn't log in. Here, should I try this 1300? Might I have a chance against him? Sure. A non-rated game. So he might accept, he might not. Okay, he refuses my challenge. Here's a 1,000. I might have some chance of beating the 1,000. No, that would be mean. He is looking for an opponent. Okay, we got a 3 Don. Sure. Why not? I am so gonna get dunked on this game. All right. What's that? I've not seen that one before. Okay. Okay. There must be some purpose to this. Let's get the king out of here. Just bring all the generals forward. Create all the holes in the world. So that does patch this hole. But at the same time, it burdens his silver a bit to be on this diagonal. So all of my guys huddle behind the line. Oh, traditionally this is where a rook lift would go in, but he might drop a bishop to counter the rook lift. Starting to think I should use the other general. Okay. What do I do about this pawn? It's such a nuisance. There's got to be something I can do, but what? Let's just keep marching the generals forward. I'm so paranoid about things landing on my back row that I'm afraid to move my guys forward. I need some space for the knight. You know, this is not how you want to develop a knight, but I don't know. I might be forced to develop it that way. Hey, what's up? Just playing some shogi against professionals, or guys that are maybe as strong as professionals. It's a bit challenging. I mean, yeah, I keep cluttering my position by moving pieces in clumsy ways, but I think this is the best way forward. And I guess next I'm gonna be moving my gold toward the middle. Oh, is he seriously pushing that? Why would he push that? Am I overextended? Or did he just really want an open line? Yeah, it'd be nice if the tiles were. Oh. Yeah, I guess you're not the one playing the game, so having the tiles be colored would be a huge benefit. Since I'm the one playing it, I remember which pieces I've moved, but yeah, colored tiles would be really nice. In some way, most of the pieces look pointed. I don't know how better to explain it than that, but you can kind of tell from the orientation of the piece, what side it's on. He's got a bishop and a pawn in hand. I'm not sure what's going on. What's he planning? What could you possibly do with a bishop and a pawn in hand? So, I do want to stop his silver advancing. I also want to be able to break these lines open somehow. We're gonna use the knight, 'cause why not? I'm sure there's a really good reason why not, but I just don't see it. Oh, if I place it here, it just does rook takes. So I'd have to put it up there. That's not so hot. Wait, I can push here. I push, he takes, I take, if I want to. Maybe I don't. Alright, we're banking it all on this because I'm very fatigued and not exactly calculating well at the moment, so gotta bank it on something. Oh, this is defended. Right. Okay. So, even the tactical justification of my really weird plan is itself compromised. So, what am I supposed to do here? My whole point was that I was going to attack this thing. I guess I am still kind of threatening that. Like, if he does some weird move and I place the pawn here, he does rook takes, then I take his knight check. That's basically the only threat I have in this position. But he's probably not going to play something weird. He's probably just going to play a common sense defensive move here. Of which I see a few, so. Yep, that's the one I was expecting. And now I go back somewhere, probably here. Well, so the plus side is now I've got this pawn, two pawns that I'm able to drop whenever I feel like it. But there's only two files I can drop them on. Understandably, he gets a bit anxious about my potential to drop things. Also, he wants to just use his piece. I could repeat the theme, but why? I mean, it gains me a tempo every time I repeat it, but it does not help me as far as I can see. Still, it does gain a tempo. To what end? Where do my pieces belong in this position? I don't see anything outright wrong with this, so I'm gonna do it. Sad they have only pawns in hand. It'd be fun to drop other things. Well, I guess I sack my pawn and I could drop a pawn here and then trade my knight for. Yeah, let's try that. That looks like something I can try. Okay, so he's hitting my bishop. That's the point. That's why he wanted that exchange. Okay. So get the trading a bishop for a silver would be bad. So I gotta move my bishop elsewhere. Still, what's going on here? Have I left some hole wide open or something? Hey, welcome. Why is my opponent not placed his bishop? Let's check. I can't exactly ignore the check. So, I mean, I get that the pieces he has in reserve are stronger than the ones I have in reserve. Definitely see that. But is that cause for worry? Okay, so I've got to run here. He's gonna check me with that. Okay. So, unless I can find some counterattack, maybe I can. The longer I wait to counterattack, the more serious this gets. Like he's threatening to go back here, hit my bishop, and then push this again. He might have other threats too. Okay. Yeah, no, this is one of the first things I saw. I forgot to mention it, but I did see this. Oh, let's check. I can't just completely ignore it. Well, my golds are attacked. He's getting one of my golds for his silver. I'm guessing he's going to promote that with check. So he's going to have a gold and a bishop in hand. Which together are enough to formulate a simple checkmate. If my king gets trapped. His king is behind this really, really nice shield here. Lance, knight, gold, silver. My king's sitting wide open because the last few games I tried to spend some turns moving my king to safety, and all it did was just make my king more endangered. Okay. Well, if I take that, he probably places one of his pieces back here, and I might be done for. So I should probably do something else. On the other hand, if I just allow this trade to happen, I can't do king takes because he's got this fork winning the rook. So I'm kind of forced to take this, although taking it is extremely dangerous. Because he checks me, I move. I'm not sure what follows. Truly between a rock and a hard place here. Well, I could just grab the material and see what happens, because I'm not seeing anything better. Jeez. This is terrifying, man. I don't want to do that. I mean, I guess, regardless, he could always place his bishop back here and promote it, and I'm in pretty big doo-doo. So I should at least take the material for being in this doo-doo. Oh, he places it there. This allows him to continue the attack with tempo. Do I have any tempo gaining moves? I think I have one. It's not good enough. Oh, jeez, this is painful, man. So, I don't want to sack the rook, though. I can't do that. His defenders near his king are way too strong. So we'll say yikes and just run like this. I am getting killed here. Okay, so this knight defends the other knight. Oh. Wait, no, I'm sorry. Yeah, can he take that? Bishop takes, rook takes check, king takes. And he's got a wave of pieces all waiting to kill me. All this because I wanted to defend my knight. So, not sure what to do. Yeah, now that's even stronger. Holy moly, that's strong. So, this doesn't do anything. In fact, that just sacks my. Okay. Here we go. I'm gambling a pawn and sacking the knight while I'm at it, but the point is that this is the whole combination that I had in mind, which is never working, which is why I've never played it. But here, with my back to the wall, I need something to plug the file, and so I'm forced to play this combination, which I know doesn't work. So the main question is, how does he crush it? Not does he, but how does he do it? So he's got the pawn. I just keep attacking. Oh. Wait. Okay. So, I mean, the silver doesn't cover this square. What else do I do? I mean, this seems reasonable-ish. I don't know. I'm flustered, so I'm just moving at this point. I'm super duper flustered. Maybe the piece here would have been stronger. I guess no, he would just go off to the side, either side, and yeah, no, I played a good move, I think. It's good enough to make him think. But he's got two golds and another pawn just waiting to drop on my king. Not counting the fact that he's winning this pinned knight, and that nothing's defending this pawn. But other than the fact that my attack isn't going very far and I'm dropping most of my pieces, if you ignore that, I'm doing okay-ish. Playing a 3-don here, so we should expect a bit of a fight. Sure, why not promote? Okay. So that's kind of what I was hoping for, is the king move. Just because I don't see a purpose to the king move. Now he's got four generals in hand. So, I should get ready to get dunked on, basically. Oh, sorry, I doubled my pawns. I thought I was going to make it a day without doubling my pawns. Turns out I was wrong. He's probably ticked that I'm a one-don-ish player on this site. I don't know. But let's suppose I didn't do that. Let's suppose I did some respectful move. Like this. So I check. I expected king takes, and I don't have a follow-up. Which is why I didn't do this. Yeah, no, I just have nothing here, man. Able to lure the king into position to do nothing to him. Yeah, double pawns are OP, which is why they're banned. They're verboten. You cannot double pawns in this game. Because double pawns are extremely powerful. So, I lost two games today. Static Rook versus Fourth File Rook was the one opening. Static Rook versus Central Rook was the other opening that I lost today. Static Rook just means I'm not changing what file my rook is on. And fourth file and center refers to where my opponent's rook is. So that most recent game, he put his rook on the center file and just obliterated my king. And my attack didn't go anywhere. So, should we try something for a slightly different pace? What is Gold Palm 2's rank? Where is he in this list? 12-18. He's a 5Q. I want to win a game today. Be so nice to win one. Let's try something a bit faster. I suspect he's going to reject my challenge because I'm way higher rated. But, oh, okay. Sorry, yeah, you're right. I should greet first. Oh, would it not be nice to win a game? Why don't I mimic that formation? I'd be a bit slower to mimic it, but yeah, let me try that. It can't be too terrible. You do have to advance all your guys sooner or later. Ooh, no, I have to get my bishop off this file. Oh, but I've moved my gold. No, my gold used to be next to my king. So it's not like the knight potentially hanging was something caused by this setup. He's trying to activate his bishop is what he's doing. I think he's being successful so far. All right, here we go. Right. Of course. Sure, why not? Let's promote. So he's trying to be tricky with his bishop on the first rank. I just don't think it's necessarily as tricky as he hopes for. Let's lift the rook. Okay, he blocks my bishop. Double pawns. Oh, I'm so bad. I am the pawn doubler. Okay, sorry about that. Okay. Yeah, I'm not so good at this. Wait. Okay, so I might be demoted if I lose my next game. Probably depends who my opponent is. Double pawns are definitely OP. Man. Okay. Got a 2Q. Sup, dude? Here, I'm just gonna push this. Forget the bishop. Now he puts his rook behind this to try to amplify it somehow. I'm going to assume that this defense somehow holds it. It being whatever it is that I'm supposed to be holding. Okay, see? He's hammering everything at this point. I'm actually going to use my generals and leave the knights at home for once. Because those knights are not so effective, I'm finding. As if that's any kind of surprise. Basically, long range pieces are way more effective than short range pieces. And in this game, a knight is definitely a short range piece. Yeah, so how's he defending this again? With the bishop. Why would you use the bishop to defend that? Oh, he's not defending. Okay. Do I bother? Maybe I want exchanges, but no. Why exchange when I can just threaten to win material? Also, this bishop is not well placed. Yeah, no, this is just incredibly unwise for my opponent. I don't think he can bring up enough pieces to support that. Oh, and besides, I can easily kick the bishop. Maybe my silver's not on a good square, though. Man, if I had a pawn in hand, I could just place it there and take his knight. Living the big dream there, eh? Still, it's not nothing. I take, we trade, created all kinds of weaknesses, but after that I could. No, I can't place the pawn there, because that'd be double pawns. Okay. If I push this, pawn takes. No, I'm forgetting how pawns move in this game. No, if I push, pawn takes, trade here, bishop takes, bishop takes, rook takes, place my bishop there, rook takes, he's threatening my knight. There's a light at the end of the tunnel, and that light is an oncoming train. It's basically what I'm gathering from all these lines. I don't want to be in the middle of all that. All right. So, also I could have considered silver forward and just kick the rook. This bishop is super active here. I'd love to counter it if I could. Am I dying if I play that? Probably not. This is probably okay because his bishop's in front. That's definitely not where the bishop belongs. So, I can afford the time to move my silver. Yeah, of course he pushes. That's the natural response. And, I mean, he pushes, I take, and then I just plug the hole back here. And he hasn't really made too much progress, but I haven't lost any either, so it's kind of a wash. Unless I have some way to trap his rook, which would be fantastic. I doubt it. I really doubt that I have some way to do that. I could consider trying. Like, silver here. He's got only a pawn to place. I guess he could place it there. I place my pawn here. I'm trapping a rook, aren't I? No, because the rook just takes here. So, attempts to trap the rook are futile. Rooks are just too powerful in this game. Alright. So he's trying to take advantage of my awkwardness here. I could try to do likewise. I could push here. Again, pull off this exchange that wins his knight. Doesn't seem to do much more than that. I do this, he, yeah, I'm undermining my pieces. Yeah, no, I'm overextended here. I need to be less afraid of advancing my rook. Sure, let's promote. Just be careful not to double my pawns again. This is the correct file to put it on. So I've hemmed in that knight. Whoopee! I guess, yeah, now I could go forward, right? I'm supported here. Oh, nothing would support my silver if he took here. wait, no, my bishop would. I'm supported if I try that. The problem is if he just pushes past, and everything breaks loose. Which I mentioned earlier and I forgot about. So he just pushes the pawn and I don't get to take it. It's a bit more complicated than that, but not very much. How do I make some sense of this now that we're here? Okay. Well, that makes my decisions a lot easier. Alright, I've got 9 pawns on the board already. Sacking the bishop would be hugely unwise. Could place a gold up here, hit the rook. Where's the rook going? Rook's going here. Look, if I give him a tempo, he just places his silver here, and it's a little difficult for me to break through again. Actually, it's not so terrible for me to break through. He's got multiple weak points, which could both be covered with a single piece. Here we go, I guess. I hope I haven't bungled this. I think that attack on the rook takes precedence over everything else on the board. So now I run back. Did I just trap my gold? Hope it was for a good cause, if that's what happened. I can't drop that. Yeah, this is how we get some initiative started, I guess. So I get the knight. And I get to promote one of my two pieces while I get the knight. What's this? Rook takes. What's he doing? Is this some kind of sacrifice? He wants me to weaken my center. Because if he gets a gold, I mean, the gold itself doesn't kill me, so. All right. That's the point. But I could, like, I have counter-attacking options here. Oh, it's scary that my back rank's wide open. But what better way to live? Okay, I kind of have to take that. Why would you sack that? Is it really that worth it to my opponent to get a promoted bishop? I guess so. Just walk away. I don't have to take that. In fact, I could take up here too. Oh, goodness. That makes things complicated if I take there. So he's threatening to take my rook. I could threaten to take his rook. Hopefully, I'm playing this accurately. I really don't like the idea of exchanging rooks with such a chaotic position. I guess fortunately it didn't come to that. Oh, now I just take this. I could exchange bishops here, and I probably should. I get huge initiative here. Can I do better? Maybe. Oh, he's hitting this. That is such a cowardly move on my part. Okay. Is this China? Yeah, this is Japanese chess. Sorry, I'm in huge time pressure. I don't have so much time to explain the rules at the moment. So this is a bishop. It moves just like a normal bishop. That's just a normal rook. That's a king. The knight only moves forward two and then to the side. The rest of the pieces are basically generals, and can only move one square at a time. Oh crap! Oh, okay. I did not see that. So you got to promote a piece. I thought I had something clever. I don't. Ooh, I seriously don't have something clever for that. All right. There is no such thing as defense in shogi, apparently. Just not seeing how to finish this. Okay, so he's gonna take my rook and have a general right next to my king, which is bad. But I didn't see any way to avoid it. Okay, so I'm in huge trouble. I cover the square next to my king in case he places a rook somewhere nearby. I just needed to run with my king, actually. I'm in huge time pressure and trying to explain things, and that's a terrible mistake here. I have no time to explain things. Yeah, no, I'm not going to win this game at all. I risked demotion by playing this, and yeah, I'm almost certainly going to lose my one dan ranking for the way I'm playing this. I need to find some way to attack, and I'm not able to place my pawns on the same file where I already have a pawn. So that makes pawn placement incredibly difficult here. I do not know why he hesitates. I mean, I'm sure I would hesitate in his shoes too, but he's killing me here. So yeah, the lance only goes forward, the pawn only goes forward. Yeah, most pieces are generals that move one square at a time. You can kind of see from their shape how they move. Maybe he's hesitating because he's trying to find a checkmate. Okay, so he moves his rook onto the back rank, and it's promoted, and now moves like a rook or a king. Threatening to take this, also threatening bishop takes lance, but who cares about the lance? Right, so that's check. Now one thing you learn in this game is that the king has to run to safety. Unlike in chess, where you actually want to take things and try to stand your ground, in shogi, standing your ground is a perilous move, and you don't do it. Alright, so that bishop's going to be strong once it moves away, and promotes. But as it stands, it's not attacking anything. Check. Oh, if I come up with some kind of attack here, I don't know. That would be unbelievable. So, at the moment I'm safe, but as soon as he starts placing more pieces, I'm going to be in grave peril. Maybe I needed to move my bishop a bit further forward. just to give my king more room to escape. Maybe this is not the right square to allow my king to race up the board, try to escape the rook. I don't know what he's doing. Why would you do that? They're literally playing with fire. I guess this isn't defended, so there is some utility to that move. Check. I mean, I wonder if my opponent knows, like, you're supposed to go after the king. I mean, he must know because he's a 2Q, but what is he doing? If there's some weaving a mating net sort of thing here, I'm not seeing it. Oh. Okay, so apparently I just sacked my rook or something like that. So I assume he's going to play knight takes here. He's just banking on my not having a mating net. Which maybe he's right, but I hope he's not. Okay, so man, these golds are difficult to pierce. I'm sorry, these generals. This one's a silver. The silver defends the gold. Silver defends this gold. Everything's all defended here. Very much unlike the state of my king, where everything's not defended. So I've okay. Well, let's check, 'cause I'm forced to take it. What the heck? Okay, he's trying to encase my king. That's the point. But now he's run out of pieces to deliver checkmate. So okay, he's got the rook on the back rank, sure. What a mess. This evens the score. This. Oh. Oh, now I get what's been going on this whole time. He doesn't know which piece is which. He's not playing with the same set I'm using. That's why none of his moves make any sense. Oh. Either that or he's got some larger problem, but I wager that he just doesn't know which piece is which. It's probably that simple. That's awful. If I manage to lose this, shame on me. I might manage to lose it. We'll see. So I place my big pawn in the center. Right, I can't take that. Oh, wow, what an emotional game. That's seriously annoying. I don't know what to do. I do the best I can in this situation. So I have a knight in hand, finally. Which gives me some hope that I might maybe somehow win this. I don't have a silver. Hopefully I don't hang the rook. Oh, damn it. Okay, so I'm losing material. I've got to sack the damn rook. Jeez, that's not good. Of course, that allows a second rook fork, but what's the point? Now I'm just trying to bully and intimidate here. I don't have a concrete plan. I'm trying to find one, but I'm not seeing a damn thing. Yeah, and that's exactly my reaction, Llama Lord. How the crap am I a 1500? I don't know. 1500s are supposed to not play like total dum-dums. Okay, at least he took the piece. At least one of us is sane. That's not my piece. I keep forgetting knights can't go backwards, too. I'd be lucky if I could remember most of these rules. I'm back to losing badly again. Okay, let's check. If I step away, I'm sure. Yeah, he just places a pawn there, I'm mated. So now he's got another really strong rook right next to my king. I'm just dead here. I got a silver. Silvers this time does not help me. Not even close. Jeez. Let's pretend this somehow helps. No, I see the mate. Yeah, this is the trickiest one I can do. It's not tricky enough. Oh. And mate. Wait, why did he take that way? Okay, now this is checkmate. Yeah, this is checkmate. All right, so, yeah. Oh, what an awful game. Okay. So, this game, I vowed not to move my knights early in the opening because moving knights early in the opening has led to problems. So there was a lot of piece shuffling this game. I did manage to get something of an attack there. I took there. I retreated, so I did manage to win a little bit of material in the opening. Got a rather dubious position. Oh, something around here caught. Yeah. I don't know. I fully expected he just trade down on this square. Like, gold takes silver. Oh, pawns don't take that way. So I was just hallucinating, basically. I took the free thing and took the rook. Hit that. Got the rook. And protected this, but in so doing, walked into a tactic. And gave back the rook. And, so here I'm just getting kicked over and over and over. So I start an attack. I check, and I just start taking things. He gives up a bishop, plays this weird move, and he's preparing to try to mate me or something. I can't really tell, but I fork a king and the rook. And I'm not happy that I lost that. We'll put it that way. So I don't know. Yeah, I'm not sure. The site gives you an initial rating of 1500. I got the 1 Don ranking because one of my early games I was playing against a 4 Don. Yeah, I know what you're trying to say. Yeah. I want to say that my opponent did not know how the pieces, like, was not able to recognize the pieces. I really think that that's what it had to do with. I don't know. Like, would it be okay if I do want to play, but would it be okay if we could delay this game for another time? I've lost like 6 games in a row here. And this one is not the one, I don't know. It's not one that encourages me to want to play more games tonight. I do want to play, but just not tonight. If that's okay. It's just incredible that here I am. I've got this rook, this rook, this bishop, and this bishop. My opponent doesn't have a darn thing, and I still managed that I haven't studied mating problems. And I know it's important to study them, but I mean, here there is no like mate in 10 or mate in 20. There's nothing like that here. Here you just have to outplay your opponent and break down their fortress, and I don't know how to do that sort of thing. So I don't think it's a matter of studying mating puzzles, or I could study tons and tons and tons of what I need is to learn the kanji pieces. Well, yeah. That was my impression at first, is that this set is hideous. I'll certainly take that under advisement. Because yeah, that was my initial impression too, is that this set is just plain hideous and difficult to watch and look at. And kanji is supposed to be, I mean, everybody uses the kanji. I'll definitely take that under advisement. I don't know. It might be a bit more challenging me for me to do that than for some other people. I don't know, I just find it after looking at a screen all day, as I tend to do for work, it's really difficult to try to go read things. It's just exhausting. And somehow I find this kind of graphic set a lot easier to work with, but I do need to learn the kanji at some point, just so I can have that option. That way, people might actually watch my stream more. Or, I don't know, there's so much more that'd be open to me if I did that sort of thing. Oh, here's where, yeah. Here's where I just effed up royally. And obviously, I need to play better, but this kind of play is just inexcusable and shows like I don't have any idea what I'm doing. So, how did this go? I take that, he takes back. And this is the sort of thing I need to figure out, is how do I play this position? I'm gonna save this one. Share Khifu. If that's how you pronounce it. So I'm going to preserve that Khifu. See, where is my collection? Maybe I just need to start a second collection here somewhere. I need to figure this kind of position out. This one really shouldn't be that hard. Or at least I need to understand the basics of how do you play once you're up this much material. I just couldn't figure out for the life of me how to break down these five generals around the king. And I don't even have a knight in hand. Like, my knight in hand is my preferred weapon of choice. It's a lot easier to break things down with that. And what I have is a whole bunch of valuable pieces that I'm afraid of losing. I mean, maybe I need to give myself a little bit of a break here. Maybe this isn't so terrible that I lost it. I need to look at more games and understand what to do with the pawns. On this game, I've only moved three pawns. Actually, this one, yeah, no, that did move. Pawns always start on the same rank. So I've moved three pawns this game, and my pieces had difficulty advancing. So I really need a better appreciation for what to do and how to use the pieces and pawns together. Obviously, dropping the lance on the board is a huge strategic error. But I don't know. Oh yeah, my weapons of choice, typically the knight in hand, or a bishop in hand. Second weapon of choice is just keep dropping pawns in the opponent's face. But here I've got pawns on every file except the third file or seventh file. So this is the only area where I can really drop pawns with strong effect. Maybe this position isn't so simple after all. Maybe I can give myself a break. That and really, I'm curious. There must be some way to break it down, but it must involve pawns. And I shouldn't have gotten into this position in the first place. It's perhaps the larger point. It's okay if I blow this, because it's, I don't know, winning games can be tricky. So I have to just allow myself to let that sort of thing go. But, really, the larger lesson is that I shouldn't be in this kind of position in the first place, and I should understand what's going on.